So till now we did not get the syllabus for this coding lab. So we'll practice more programs on coding. On this session, we'll practice more programs on coding. Okay.
Ma'am, it's language, ma'am.
See, today we'll practice the programs on C program only because today is the first session, right? From next lab onwards, whatever the language, if we got as per our syllabus, that we may follow. Okay, Sharat?
Okay, ma'am.
Today we'll do like a practice session, ma'am. What we have, once we'll revise all the concepts, what we have learned in the previous semester. Okay. Now, what we discussed in recent. What we discussed in the previous semester.
Design and analysis of algorithms.
See, not the subject in the coding lab, what we have seen.
C programming basics to data structures.
C programming basics to data structures we have seen, right?
Yes, ma'am.
See, entire C programming, I'll conclude it, ma'am. I'll tell you how we have learned the things. How many data types we have? Can anyone please respond? How many data types we have? How many, ma? Nalini? Two ena manakundi. Before going to types of data types, what is the data
type?
What is the data type? Coding ki nene namma meeku.
Yes, ma'am.
Chusara, mee timetable lo. Ma'am, please respond fast.
Yes, ma'am.
Chusava, seshu timetable lo.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Mari CS9 vallu nannu adugutunnaru. Okka nimisham amma. I'll check and get back you.
Okay, ma'am.
Sim 5 combine చేసేయాలా section I and section K both ఉన్నాయి. I అంటే CS9 ఆ? Okay. wait 2 minutes, ma. The remaining people are joining. Okay, ma'am. Is it visible to you, my whiteboard?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Can anyone tell me what is the data type? Please respond, any of you. CS9 as well as CS11 people.
Data is anything that can be used and processed. It can be of like any types. It can be like numbers, alphabets.
Okay. The data type means the name itself. Saying that the data type describes about the type of data. Okay. The data type itself describes about what type of data you are going to use in your program. That is nothing but the data type. So entire programming is depends on the data types only. So how many classifications are there in data types? How many classifications are there?
Arithmetic, Boolean.
What my arithmetic?
Boolean, ma'am.
I didn't get you. See, any other answers can I expect?
Primitive, it's divided into primitive and non-primitive. In that. Types will be there, ma'am.
Primitive and non-primitive. Only two types, primitive and non-primitive. Okay. Okay, as per my knowledge, data types are of four types. See, what you are telling, primitive and non-primitive, those are not data types. Those are data structures, not data types. As per my knowledge, data types I can classify into primary, secondary, or else you may call this as derived, and user defined, as well as void. How many are there here?
Four, ma'am.
Four: primary, secondary or derived, user defined, and void. Your entire C programming is nothing but this is the only thing what you have learned in your entire C programming. What are primary data types? Primary data types can be primary means it is integer, character, float, and double. This is primary data types. What about secondary or what is another name? Derived. Before going to derived, what is the situation that made us to go derived? What is the situation means here? Int means used to represent the numbers. Char means used to represent the characters. Float means the data which is adequate, which means is continually changing. For example, the temperature. Now the temperature is 20.2. After some time it is 0.7. After some time at afternoons it may be 30 degrees. So it is not constant always. It is changing continuously. It is a changing parameter. That's why those things or decimal points, those can be represented using the float data type. And double. Double is also used to represent the decimal points. What is the difference between float and double? What is the difference between float and double? Can anyone?
In float, we store a number with points.
What is double? See, float and double both are used to represent the decimal point numbers. Then what is the difference between float and double? For example, 15.6372879 is there. Okay. Is it possible to represent this number using float? Yes. Or no?
No, ma'am. You can't show it in the float.
Float use just thing in represent cheyagalana?
No, ma'am.
No. Why?
It takes only some small numbers, some limited numbers after the point, ma'am. The decimal.
Some limited value. Number means what is the count?
3 or 4.
3 or 4. No, ma. Floating point number means you can represent up to 6 digits after the decimal point. So 7th digit is there, no, so it cannot able to represent. If the situation is like this, we'll go for double. Float and double both are used to represent the decimal point numbers. Then what is the difference means after operation, float can able to represent 66 numbers only. Beyond that 6 numbers, if you want to represent, then better to choose double. Got it? All the data types. Int is used to represent
integers or numbers?
Integers, numbers. Char is used to represent?
Alphabets.
Alphabets or characters. Float is used to represent?
Any number with decimal values up to
decimal point numbers. Double is also used to represent decimal point numbers, but float can able to represent only 6 numbers after a decimal point. Beyond that, we'll go for double. And the sizes simply I'm mentioning, ma, it is 4 bytes. Earlier it is 2, but now it is 4 bytes, the size of the integer. Character is 1 byte and the float is 8 bytes and the double some 10 bytes. Okay, this is primary data. Just briefly, I have explained what is a primary data type. Is anybody having doubt regarding this primary data types? Am I clear with this? Yes or no, otherwise I can't understand.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, what is the situation made us to move from primary to secondary or primary to derived? Okay, what does the situation mean? Suppose here you are 120 members, simply I'm assuming 60 from CS9 and 60 from CS11, right? So total 120 members. 120 members means I need 120 variables to store your roll numbers. Okay, for example, CS9 roll number I want to store. So 91 I'm storing, 92 I'm storing, like this. 9001, 9002, 9003. I'm storing A as 9001, B as 9002, and C as 90903. Like this, how many numbers I use? 20 roll numbers. How many variables I need? Say 120 variables I need. Okay, so it is, maybe it is easy to remember 120 numbers, but when you go to real time data, when you go to software field, suppose you want to store all of your employees TCS, example, consider TCS. TCS is a big company, so there may be thousands of employees. So it needs thousands of variables to store the roll numbers or the employees. So it's maybe little difficult. When you go to real-time data, there are millions of data, so millions of variables we need to store their particular IDs. It is not that much easy to proceed. So to avoid this, we have moved from primary data types to this derived data types. The name itself, derived. Nothing we have implemented like new. We have derived this type from the primary only. Instead of storing 120 variables, instead of taking 120 variables with one variable, in that variable itself, if I store the size within a single variable name, with a variable name A itself, from A, instead of adding the size also, I'm attaching size also to that variable A of 120, which is nothing but the derived data type. I'm not using any new derived means roll numbers means or integers. So what I'm using, int a part is up to primary. Next I'm adding this new size, then it will became the derived. Derived means I have derived that from the primary only. What is situation made me to derive something new from the primary? Primary at a time can able to store only one value. If you want to store more than one value, we have to go for derived data types. Clear?
Wow.
Okay. Can you give any example for derived data types?
Arrays, ma'am.
Arrays. Arrays is the best example for derived data types. Now I'll give you one question. All of you solve it. I'll give you one question and we'll give you 7 minutes. Please write a program in that 7 minutes. This is like, this session is like a revision session of C programming. Next, we'll move on to the next language, whatever we are having in our curriculum. Okay, so simply I'm giving you a question like, all of you write a program to search an element, or write a program to perform linear search. Andaru Rayali, write a program to perform linear search. Will you? At least I'm expecting few voices. Will you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what about CS11? Sharat, Nalini, Sheshu. Nara, CS11 wala asla? 37, Nitin, Nalini, Rishita, Sheshu, are you there? Please do it, ma. 3:25. I'll give you time up to 3:35. Please complete and tell me the logic. Completed, ma'am. Any one of you, please respond. Completed. Can you please respond? Okay, CS 1159 completed. Chepu Nikhil, 42. Completed. CS 9. Sai Chandana completed. Remaining CS 9, CS 11. Okay, still those who are having difficulty how to use this derived data types or arrays, observe carefully. Assume this is the given question. 5, 7, 8, 9, 13, 15. This is the given array. And the search element I have given you 7. Whether 7 is present in the array or not, you have to find it. Okay. Are you listening, ma? At least please respond. Those,
yes, ma'am.
Though you have completed or not. Are you listening?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, this is the first. Direct main include stdio, all those things. I'm starting with main function itself. Okay. So array of elements. Is it a single element or multiple elements? Is it a single element or multiple elements?
Multiple
elements. So I'm declaring it like an array. Array of size 10. I'm assuming there are 10 elements. Simply I'm assuming like that. Okay, so int a of 10. I have first I have to read the elements. How many elements you want to read? That's why how many elements I'm representing with n. So first I'm reading that how many elements you want. Enter how many elements you want. Okay, how many elements is I'm reading in the variable n. So percentile the address of n. Next, how many elements 1, 2, 3 is equals to 6 I have given. Next, whatever the elements you want to enter, enter it. Whatever the elements you want to enter, 6 elements. No, instead of writing 6 printf statement, I'm putting that printf statement inside the loop. So declare I is equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. How can I read? And sorry, instead of writing 6 scanfs, I'm writing it like a one. Anybody having doubt up to this point? So reading of an array is completed. Any doubt up to this point, please let me know. We have given the number of elements and we have given the array. Next. Search element you have to enter. Is anybody having doubt up to this point? Respond, ma.
No, ma'am.
Okay. Next, enter the search element. How can we write printf? Enter search element. How can we read percentile d comma? What is the search element I have assumed? It is okay. So reading of the elements and the key part is over. Key is also declared. Next, now you have to start the searching part. How can we start? Yella searches thamanam. First, we'll compare this key element with the first element. No, then we'll move on to the next. FS print it as successful. No, search until you finish all the items. So that's what I'm writing here. So from 0th element to all the elements in the array, you have to search. So I less than n, I plus plus. Any confusion in the statement why I have written for loop here? because I have to search from the starting element and I have to move to the last element. That's why I have written like a for loop. I equals to 0, I less than and I plus plus. Any confusion in the statement up to this point? No. Right?
No.
Okay. Now compare. Compare means if key is equals to A of I. If key matches with any of the element in the given array, if it matches, then printf element found. Can I close this for loop? Can I close this for loop or did I miss any statement here? See, after element found, which means 7 is equals to 5, it is not true. So again, the loop will repeat. Initially, I equals to 0, compare with A of 0, that is 7 equals to 5, condition false. So I will be incremented. 7 is equals to 7. Condition true. Condition true means it is printing element found. After that, is it necessary to check with the remaining elements?
No
means how can you come out of the
break statement?
Very nice. Break statement. So give break statement. Whenever this condition is true means we are writing a break statement. Break statement means come out of the loop. Nearby break statement is used to come out of the loop. Come out of the nearby loop. Okay, so it will come out of that. You have verified all the elements. If you reach, which means suppose same given question, if the key is 17, what you have to do? 17 equals to 5. 17 is 2 equals to 7. Condition false. Again, I will be incremented as 2. 17 equals to 8. Condition false. Again, I will be incremented. 17 equals to 9. Condition false. Again, I will be 17 equals to 13. Condition becomes false. I will be incremented. 17 equals to 15. Condition becomes false. So I will increment now. Less than 6. Condition is false. Condition is false means come out of that. నువ్వు బయటకు వచ్చేస్తావు, బయటకు వచ్చిన తర్వాత హౌ ద యూజర్ కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్ దట్ ఎలిమెంట్ నాట్ ఫౌండ్ దట్ స్టేట్మెంట్ ఆల్సో యూ హ్యావ్ టు ప్రింట్ రైట్. సో ఫర్ దట్ స్టేట్మెంట్ వాట్ ఐమ్ రైటింగ్ అబ్జర్వ్ కేర్ఫుల్లీ. ఇఫ్ ఐ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు ఎన్, వెన్ ఐ వాల్యూ రీచెస్ టు ఎన్, దట్స్ వాట్ ద ఫైనల్ స్టేట్ ఫైనల్ కండిషన్. ను ఐ వాల్యూ అండ్ ఎన్ వాల్యూ బోత్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్. వెన్ ఐ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు ఎన్, దెన్ ప్రింట్ ఇఫ్ ఎలిమెంట్ not found. See ma, some of you may think like, okay, all these things we know, like that. Some of you may think, of course I know that most of the people are familiar with this C programming, but simply in this session I'm just revising all the concepts before going to the next part. Okay, any problem with this? Are you following?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
ma'am. CS11 and CS9 people, if you are not answering, if you are not responding, means I cannot understand whether you are listening or whether you are following. This is simply an interactive session. Coding means we are together learning how to code a program. That's what I'm telling. I'm just revising all the concepts in this session. If you are familiar with this, we'll move on to the next level. Okay, so please respond. We are simply learning how to code a program. That's it. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, derived data types. Again, we'll come back to the first slide. So primary we have completed. Derived we have completed. And we are having so many examples in this primary as well as in this derived. Simply I'm giving you only one example just to revise. Next, after primary, after secondary, what is the next part? What is the next part we have seen? Primary, derived, what is the third category, ma?
User defined.
user defined. The next category is user defined. Okay, we are fine with primary and we are fine with derived. By using primary, we cannot able to store a set of numbers with a single variable name. So it is not possible. That's why we have moved to derived. Then what is the necessity to move from derived to user defined? What is the situation made us to move from derived to user defined? Can anyone please respond? Just think and respond. Primary derived is enough to do programs. Then why we have moved towards user defined?
To create the function that the user needs.
What more? 25?
To create the functions to complete a task that the user needs to complete.
Okay. Any other answers? To create a new data type. What is that new data type? 33? Varun. Sorry, not Varun. 33. CS9.
Yes, ma'am.
Chappam, a new data type ante?
Other than primary and...
Other than new data type, the primary derived kaakunda, what is the necessity to make you to create a user defined? See, ma'am, I'll give you simple. What the situation made us to move to store a couple of numbers, to store a set of numbers, right? Same as like user defined means here 120 people are here. I know how to store 120 roll numbers, but I'm not familiar to store roll numbers as well as names. Me roll number to part nak me name kuda kavali. Is it possible through derived data types? What is a derived data type? It can able to store a set of same type of data. That is, either it may store either roll numbers or names, but both it cannot. Right, so that situation made me to find a new data type. That data type they have given the name as user defined. Am I clear with this? By using user defined data types, we can able to store both roll numbers as well as names. Why they have earlier they have given derived? Because we have derived the data type from the previous one only, from the primary only. Simply we have added the size to the primary data that became derived. After that, why they have given the name as user defined? Because user defined means, see, I'm expecting the roll number and the corresponding name. Somebody else, suppose roll number one want to store like roll number and his marks. And from CS11, roll number one is going to store roll numbers as well as his address. So whatever the data you want to store, that depends on particular user. My intention is different. CS9 roll number one intention is different. Another one's intention is different. We are going to store as per our requirements. That's why they have given user defined. User will define whatever the process, whatever the order they want. That's why they have given the name as user defined. Am I clear with this? Why they have given the name as user defined? Did you understand what is this user defined data type?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so that's why we have moved from derived data type to user defined. By using derived data type, either a name or roll number, either only one, it will be satisfied. But when you come to user defined, you may store your roll number, name, marks, whatever the data you want, you can store. So can you give examples for user defined data types?
Structures and
Structures and unions. Very good. What is this? What is the difference between structure and union? What is the difference between structure and union? Can anyone tell us the Japan wrong in a structure and union? What is the difference? Both are user defined data types, both are used to store different types of data that we know. Then what is the difference? Structure satisfies the constraints. Why we have to learn union? What is the difference between these two things, structure and union? Nali, Sharat. CS9 people, are you there? 25 CS9, Chandana, 33. Please explore yourself whether it is right or wrong. Respond over simple caps and bit test.
Ma'am, in structure, if you change any value, then it does not change the all others value, ma'am. Not other variables.
Okay.
Whereas in union, if you alter the value of a variable, then it affects all other variables, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, ma'am. Between the structure and the union is that both are used to store the different types of data. Then what is the difference between these two means, structure and union means? Structure is, the difference is in the form of sizes. For example, in the structure has stored name as 20 characters and roll number simply and marks. Okay. Next, this is character type of data. This is integers, what I'm assuming. Same union also, char, name of 20, int, roll number, float, marks. Same thing I have stored. Then what is the difference? Observe carefully. What is the size of this? What is the size of that? 20. Next to this?
4.
4.
What is size of this float?
8.
Altogether, what is the size?
32.
32, ma'am.
32. Very nice. Okay, what is the size of this? 70, what is this? 20. What is the size of this?
4.
Next?
8.
Altogether?
32.
30. Which one was? See, altogether the size is not 32, altogether the size is 20. Why it is 20 means union will allocate the data only for the highest size. Okay, structure will allocate the space for all this 20 for character and 4 for roll number, integer, and 8 for floating point number. It will allocate all the values, but it will allocate only the highest size. Highest size is 20. Suppose if you want to store the name, suppose name is Geetham, it will store in this part. Suppose if you want to roll store number, it will override this Geetham with the roll number some 2001. Next, suppose if you want to store the marks, it will overwrite it with marks as 74.6, like that. Here, it will allocate like Geetham 2071 74.6. Everything is available in this structure, but here only the highest type size is available. Whatever the data you have stored recently, that is only available. Got it, ma? Did you understand the difference between both of these two, structure and union?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. This is user-defined data types, and I'll give you the program for this user-defined data type. And then we'll move on to the programs of structure and structures and unions. Okay. Now, void. What is this void type? The last one, ma. Once again. Primary we have seen, secondary we have seen, user defined. Of course, we are left with examples. Void we are going to discuss. Okay, tell me what is. Can you tell me, ma, what is void? Void means it is not going to store anything till what we discussed. Very nice. It is an empty data type which has no value, doesn't return anything. Suppose if you take this like return type, it does not return anything. Okay, void means which is simply nothing. Value. Int means it is returning integer. Char means it is returning character value. Next, after that, arrays means it is returning array of values. Structures means it is returning a structure. All these are the concepts. Void means it does not return anything. This is a situation that you don't want it to return anything. Generally, this we use like a return type only. When you don't want it to return anything, then you go for this void type of data. Clear? Sir, no.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that's why generally by default will you, by default the main return type is integer only. But if you don't want to return anything, means use void. Okay, one more question. Generally, I use it to ask the question, is main function user defined? Is main function user defined or predefined?
User.
Most of the answers I got.